12 sons. Of these 12, Joseph was his favorite. In order to show his love for Joseph, Jacob bought him a beautiful multicolored coat. Joseph's brothers were jealous. They decided to fool their father, and they tore Joseph's coat, dipped it in blood, and threw Joseph in a pit. They went to Jacob and told him Joseph was dead. They then sold him to the Ishmaelites, and he was again sold to Captain Potiphar, and, because of some wrongdoing, was thrown into prison. Joseph found he had the power to interpret dreams. The mighty Pharaoh of Egypt heard of this and summoned Joseph. Joseph told the Pharaoh that his nightmares meant that there would be 7 years of famine, 7 years of prosperity, and Egypt would thrive. But after that, a 7-year famine would devastate the land. The Pharaoh put Joseph in charge of storing grain for the famine and made him the number 2 man in all of Egypt. Joseph was right. While all the other countries of the world were starving, Egypt had plenty. Back in Canaan, Joseph's family was hard hit by the famine. They decided to go to Egypt and to beg for food. The man they had to see was Joseph. They did not recognize him. In order to test his brothers, Joseph planted a golden cup in the youngest brother Benjamin's sack and accused him of stealing it. But let's not tell all. Let's leave the ending as a surprise. Thank you.
even known. God and the King, I am most in majesty, in whom no beginning may be, and no end. I have been told of the I am, and have been ever. I have made stars and planets and their courses to go. I have made a moon for the night, and a sun to light the day also. I have made earth where trees and grasses spring,
after me shall be mightier than I. Well, I'm not fit to take off his shoes. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Do you come to me?
Well, yeah, I want to get washed up.
I need rather to be washed up by you.
No. Look, let it be so for the present. We do well enough to perform all that God requires. When wilt thou save the people? Oh God of mercy, when? The people, Lord, the people, not thrones and crowns, but
any man, therefore, set aside even the least of the law's demands, vindicate his children who cry out to him day and night while he sits patiently listening to them?
Yeah. of the master. That he condemned the man to torture.
Kill torture!
Until he could pay the debt in full.
And that is how my heavenly father will deal with you. Unless you each forgive your brothers and sisters from your hearts.
Thank you.
If your right hand offends you, I want you to cut it off and fling it away.
No. Uh-uh. No way. No. 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 No.
Okay.
No.
It's better for you to lose one part of your body than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell. But what I tell you is this. Never set yourself against a man who wrongs you. So if someone slaps you on your right cheek, turn and offer him your left.
Oh.
No.
Jesus Christ.
Always wins.
then can you be called children of your heavenly Father, who makes the sun rise and set on good and bad alike, and sends the rain on the honest and the dishonest. Now, if you greet only those who greet you, what reward can you expect? Surely a tax gatherer does much. And if you love only those who love you, what is there extraordinary in that? Even the heathen do as much. No, your goodness must know no bounds, just as your heavenly Father's goodness knows no limits.
Well, one time he looked up and body
is
the eye.